My name is Asnat Sangati. I'm a mom of five. I hail from the beautiful island of Lomati Matukulau. I have maternal links to Rev. Matukulau. I'm married to my father's children from Tavlula Inerai Lomaiviti. And I reside in Lotian Lakemba Street, Samambula. From when COVID started hitting, I was actually working and got laid off since I was on my fourth month of pregnancy, and our shop closed down. At that time, my husband got laid off too as a fruit seasonal picker. And this business I'm running, it was something motivated from my dad. It wasn't something that I was passionate about. It's a trade that I've learned. I'm a pastry chef, a profession. And when I thought of my kids and how I don't like to depend on my siblings and other people to help support my family, I thought of this business since this is what my dad said when I'm at home without work, and this is something that will help me provide for my family. So yes, I started off with roti, making roti curry around 4 a.m. every morning, selling 10 parcels. But then I had emergency caesar, so I switched to making donuts since there wasn't a lot making donuts at that time. When I was 2 weeks into labor, I've taught my husband to make it, to continue making it instead of, you know, because when you go into labor, they will, his siblings will simply and my family, and I don't like that. So I like my children to see the sacrifice and the struggle we make every day for this thing that my husband and I back to back work on. Looking after the children, and continue with our business. Plus, this business, it started off providing income and generating income for my family. But then, once I was into this business, I wanted to professionalize it. But then I waited for opportunity for a business class. But then while I was in my journey of business, I saw family struggling. So from our tithe, our 10% we get in our business a week, it goes to unfortunate families. And from our profit, half of it we just get ingredient stock to better for unfortunate families' needs. And mostly moms prepping to give birth and those kind of things. I have photos I can provide, but then I don't usually like publishing things I've already done. But yes, this business is mostly half business, half charitable business, and just trying to be independent and trying to show my kids that in this kind of crisis we're facing, it's not the hardship, it's just taking it as a challenge and moving forward. Because if you're taking it as a hardship, you will just face problems every day. So whatever we try and create at home, when it's raining we can't sell, whatever we try and create at home or just get it out of our storage, we sell it and we just do something to generate income to the family and to whichever family that that request for groceries or when they need it, especially medication and all those kind of stuff. But for this week, we're just selling this, we're selling 300 donuts every day for this week. It's going to our Samaritan box we're providing, which will be delivering on Tuesday to Delcush homes. We'll be with the two donors that's helping me. Just a regular donut customer. So we'll be providing gifts and baked goods set to those and kids from sole moms, sole parents. So yes, that's our journey. I have a wonderful husband that's been supportive through my work, and this is something that I've not only done now, but it was something I've seen my parents done in the past. And when I saw the challenges, because I've lost my dad 2 years ago, the flashback just coming, and I have kids, and I know the hardship I face every day trying to provide for my kids. So when a mom is in need, or when a dad is in need to cater for their family, I just try to reach out. I just have that full faith and reach out, because I know I'm doing it in a good heart, and the Lord will just provide. My transportation, whatever I take, the Lord will just add on to it. Yes, before I used to post up pictures of things I've done, and then family's request, but then I don't usually screen them before I reach out to them. And then after reaching out to them 2 days after, I've seen that they've taken advantage of the system. They've taken advantage of my reaching out to them. And from that time, I've switched to screening their family first, knowing the family 2 days after they reach out, and then actually reach out, so I can know that they really need the help that they're capable of receiving. So that's how.